G'day, g'day. Thanks for dropping in. Thought I would use some free time that I had to get in and do a casual draft. I managed to 7-0 a draft the other day, and then followed up with a 3-3, which is probably more accurate of what my abilities would be. So I thought I'd have some fun with it, kill a couple of hours, and yeah, see what happens. I do love Ikaria. That's the standard deck I'm playing at the moment is just the casual armory deck, which runs Ikaria. I think I just have to take her. She's a legendary. There's dusting implementations there. What am I thinking of? I don't know. And it's just a fun card. If I end up in Rakano, it's just wins games without even trying. Seems like a good place to start. Alright, follow up. We've got the revolver. It's fine. Make sure everything's working here. I like the Throne Warden. As well with weapons. Very high cost creature. Otherwise, a bunch of whatevers. The revolver, I don't think, is very, very good. Definitely streaming. Cool. I think we'll just take the warden. Sticks on colour, and it's a fine card. I'm basically building my standard deck at the moment. Don't mind the amulet. I like the bat, but I probably prefer the marshal. Don't particularly want to go three colours, but it's just probably the best card in the pack, which is what you got to look at this point of the just playing the draft. We'll take the Marshal. I don't mind this one, but you gotta have some good spells to make that worth it, and at the moment I have no good spells. I like this guy. He's real good. Then I'm gonna take the Minotaur. He's fine. He's not exciting, but he's fine. I like the Cutthroat. I like Static Bolt. I don't think a lot of people like Static Bolt, but I like Static Bolt, and that's what matters. Javelin's fine. Take the Cutthroat, I think it's just a better card. I like Rebuke. I don't mind the Scribe, nothing exciting. Daggers are good. Weapon's not terrible. But yeah, I'll take the Rebuke. Justice seems open. Infantry's better than Deputy. Deputy's just nothing. Strike's good. Ambassador, I don't think, is very exciting unless you're dedicated to Empower. I'll take the Infantry for now. Peacekeepers, yeah. Really nothing in this pack. Three for a 2/2. I like Dispel. Silence isn't a bad form of removal, generally. It's not going to take out the big creatures, but it's going to stop them doing nasty things. I'll take the Fledgling. Second dispel's less good. Ooh, cockroach. Don't think cockroach is playable as a one of. Right? think we're looking at... Yeah, we could take Clock Rage just as a 2-mana... 3-mana 2-2. Hope we get a second or third one. Or we could just play the Bright Mace Paladin, which is a 3-mana 3-3. Really just start picking up some weapons, though, if I'm going to look at this deck. I suppose I could take the War Helm. I'll take the Paladin. I still don't know if I'm going to be time, if I'm going to be fire. Could even switch out of them completely. I don't want this. This is fine, right? There's nothing else I'm going to be playing in either of those colours. Best blue card. Yeah, I'll take the Burnout. Look at the Guardian. The Guardian's a good card. Push more into time. You can't really splash that, can you? We'll take the Guardian. Again, we want to pick up weapons, basically. That's my main goal at the moment, is to find weapons. He's good. There's one. Yeah. Yep. So we're not going to play the Cutthroat. We'll take the Seek Power in case we do want to... In case we want to get greedy. That might help go some more colours. Aspirin's fine. Probably not playing that. I do like this if we're playing red. I'll go up for 3 drops. Yeah. Don't particularly want anything higher. I've got a couple of fives and some sixes. I really want to get more low to the ground. I need more 2 drops than 3 drops. Take this. I don't know if I'm playing fire yet, but we'll take it. Awakened Student definitely makes me want to play Combray, I don't know how to say it. If we say it. How are my 4 drops looking? I've only got the 1, so I'll take the Guardian. It's not horrible, it's fine, it's better than this thing, and I'll get a Dispel if I want a Dispel. Take another Fledgling, whether I play it or not. Basically just building up a creature base. Strange is fine. Yeah, I'll take another one of these. It's not the best weapon you're going to find, but it's fine. If you stick it on your Karmic Guardian and start hitting for 5, then... Yeah. This is good. Helps me splash. Inspire's solid. I'm not sure why Inspire's coming around so late. I don't mind having... one of Decay. Never played this, but it seems fine. And probably not. Ooh. Hey, awesome, thanks for the follow, Anonymous. If that's really your name, that's pretty cool, because... Yeah. So I've got the Enforcer, which is probably just the auto take here, but I could happily take another Throne Warden, and I mean Lightning Storm's a great card. But yeah, we'll take the Enforcer. It's got flying, it's got silence stuff, it's a 3-3 for 3. It's just tick tick tick. So I'm basically building this deck which could go either Combray, Bracano, or I don't know, Combracano, or whatever we call that combination of the two. I really wouldn't mind another Desert Marshal, but I think I'm going to take the Longsword here. Let's do a creature count. One. Again, I'm not playing that. Screw that. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. So I got plenty of creatures. Yeah, I'll take the longsword. Wait, I took the paladin. Could be wrong. Let's see what happens. There's the longsword. Could have taken it. Ceremonial Mask. Never played before, but I'll give it a shot. I don't mind this thing. It's more of a defensive card, and I don't know if I'm super defensive here. I can always take the 3-2 for 2. Definitely, yeah, I need some 2 draws. Let's take the 3-2. Let's take the rare. Not unplayable, right? You often find yourself getting a place where you can only attack with one creature, especially if you've got flyers and stuff out. I don't know. I'll take the Tower Top. Will I? Tower Top or Soldier? I'll take the Soldier. Which Warcry guy? So, which Warcry or double damage chick do I want? That's the question. We've already got a bunch of 2-drop creatures, so where's my 3-drop? Yeah, I'll take the 3-drop. I'll take this one. I'm more likely to play this, because I don't know if I'm playing red or not. Take a weapon, probably won't play it. Definitely play that. Won't play that. Alright, that wasn't terrible. I've definitely picked up worse piles. I'm at 26 here, so I can cut some units. No. Probably not. Buy that back if I want to. Serapod Wrangler, 5 costs. I really want to play this, but I think it's greedy. I've got the one Stranger, the one Seek Power. And that's it. Yeah, so I'd say, let's just try, we'll get rid of all the fire cards, just to see what it looks like. Where's the... Oh, I'm not playing that, because that's not even a colour. And where's the Crown Watch Deserter? Let's make some cuts. Cut that. Probably cut that. Seems fine, but just having creatures better. We're not playing 3 cards, so I'll get rid of that. Oh, sorry, that was the other way of fixing, so I had exactly 3 forms of fixing. So I need to cut about 5 more cards. I hate cutting in this game. It's so much harder for some reason. So I can afford to cut a couple of creatures. I mean, it's Wrangler. So what have I got? I've got 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I've got a ton of 2-drops. I can probably cut this. Because this is literally not doing anything. Yeah, we'll cut that. It's the worst of the 2-drops. So if we are do like all of my three drops. I want to keep my high end up at least a bit. Could cut the mace, I guess that's not doing. What do I have in terms of removal? We've got double rebuke, dispel, and the mark of shame's kind of removal, right? Probably cuts the sick power, yeah. We're very light on time, so. As in time cards, so probably not going to be playing too many sigils. It's probably worth having it still. Lose some one drops. What have I got? I like the assailant. I like them both though. Maybe I'll lose decay. I can do so much stuff though. See what Discord has to say. I love Discord. I only discovered Discord this week and it's just so helpful. Yeah, we could cut decay. I mean, we could cut one of the rebukes. Definitely look at losing one of the one drops. Okay, I don't want to reduce my high end at all. Two drops. So we'll cut the infantry possibly. I don't want to cut any more creatures other than that. So I need to cut either spells or attachments. What's the fifth one? No, the marker change is the fifth one. Spells. Decay, inspire, seek power. Just keep it maybe inspire. Don't like inspire? What? The Discord saying treasure guard, peacekeeper, maybe inspire. Peacekeeper, I suppose he's only 3/3. Decay could be cut. Yeah, let's do cut decay. Cut peacekeeper, that puts me to 17. With the seek. Actually, I'll probably go to 16 with the seek because it's pretty low to the ground. So maybe I'll add back in the one drop. Mark of Shame and the Aspirant. Getting a few different messages from Discord. The mark. Yeah, late game drop. That immune, so we're going to go to 16 sigils. Yeah, we'll do that. Really? The path for the oath book's really good. I don't know if you're trolling me. It feels like you might be trolling me. It seems okay, but not that good. Do it like that, 10-6 time. Probably just go 9-7 just to even it up. I want to play it. I suppose, I don't know. We can only try it, I guess. Yeah, that'll do. It's not no point sitting around talking about it all day. As we'll play with it. We can always change it later. Alright. Combrice stuff. Let's see what happens. Okay, yeah, I suppose kind of guy would be pretty nice, especially if I weapon it up a bit. Ob's redrawing this hand, it's literally unplayable. That's better. Pretty obvious, start out with the turn one that. Get some damages in. Question is, do I put this on this, or do I put on the good creature? Oh, mirror match. Let's do it, put on the guardian, of course. But we'll do it like this, then I need to make sure I hit white source. Enter. So next time we want to drop the guardian, the turn after we want to sort it up. And hit for lots. Opponents doing stuff. We can't attack with that one. Yet. Mine's bigger. All according to plan. You could triple block this, but whatever. Okay. I guess we kill the... is it better to kill the Guardian or the other two creatures? I'm not too worried about the Guardian. I'm going to kill... I'm going to kill these two. Own the board. If I put up... weapon up this guy, spread my threats out a bit. Yeah, there goes that. Ah, what the... yeah, what's the chances of that? What are the chances? Oh well, I still get to hit for 9. Well, 3 if he doesn't block. Yeah, yeah. No, because it just makes, what's that, 3, it makes it 5, so it's not worth it. Let's hit him for 9. Alright, I'd like to draw a third creature for the game, would be nice. I could just draw sigils, that's fine too. I'll put it on in this time, that way next turn I can ultimate him to... it'll be what, 5 plus 2 plus 2, so it'll be 9 damage. That's not terrible. It's a race that I win. Guess my opponent has... oh, that has Echo, so okay, yep. Helps if I know what cards do.
Why didn't he?
Not a fast spell. Yep. Helps if I'm not an idiot. Surprise. What do I get? Ooh. I mean, that's fine. I'd got the sigil, that would be nice, but I guess we just start flooding the board a bit. I need to kill that. I don't know what I, what I have to kill that. I took out my decay, yeah, that'll kill it. Yes. No attacks. Oh, I drew a card. Wow. This is not working for me tonight. Question is, what am I giving? I can play this. I can give the plus 1 to... sorry, the plus 4 to... this thing. Seven quick draw. Opponent doesn't have to block it, they can just take it. Where should I? Because they can just block. So I can attack with more, but they can just block and gain the life back, so it's not not optimal. Go to hell. Alright. hope that my opponent doesn't draw any more creatures. And we can win. That's all we've got to hope for. Hey, it's a false prince. There's a sigil which does nothing for me. Attack for three, chump for days. I'll hold that, because there's no reason to play it. Yeah, so I suppose if he'd blocked the Huru, then he would have gained some life, but I could have killed it. Yeah, no. Alright, we managed to fluke out, put ourselves in a good spot with two lethal attackers. But yeah, I definitely see what you're saying with... Cool. So yeah, if I'd attacked with the fledgling and the opponent decided to block, then would have worked out well for me. I completed a quest. I like completing quests. Whatevs. Cool. Alright, let's just double check. Just run back the deck, see if there's anything else we want to change here. Yeah, I fluked out the one silence that didn't get, or the, what was it, the rebuke that didn't get countered, so that's how you kill Karmic Guardians. Or just turn them into Infernuses, whatever. Yeah, so that, I'm going to go with you there, Mind Control, that definitely would have been good if I'd drawn that, because it's just, yeah, making my guys bigger and bigger. Still like all the cards that we've got. I don't think there's anything that's particularly bad. Yeah, we'll run it back as it is. Right, see if we can 7-0 again. Somehow we flicked out a 7-0 on Saturday night. It's a definitely fluke. Olmi 91. Yeah, I'll keep this one. Play this, play this, play Sigil. Yeah. Oh, I can't cast this, so it's going downside. That's fine. I'm sure I've got 10 of the 9 of the bloody things, so. Block that. This game screws me by not drawing a second Justice Source, I'm going to be annoyed. Block. Whenever I see things like that, I tend to block quickly. Play a 3-3. So we're going to suit him up. And we're going to sit back on the defense, are we? Or we're just going to silence that now to turn off Warcry. I think we need to turn off Warcry. Yeah. Better than nothing, I guess. Play that next turn. This is Warcry. Okay. Getting outgunned here. Seriously? there's the green sauce that we wanted. So now I can just slam this guy to turn this off. Now we just wait. Yeah. We'll get some damage in. Yeah, we'll play a jumper. I'll trade my dude with that. I suppose you're not going to get 5 units from the void. It's 1. No, I don't think he should attack. It's not sensible. I want to put the glaive on this one to get some damages in, get some life links in. This time we can block. He can give it overwhelm. I take 6 damage and he gets a 1-1 and a 3-2. Yeah, whatever. Hopefully my opponent doesn't draw any flyers and I just win. Get some armor next turn if I want. Make sure I don't give him a way to put a flyer into my graveyard. Cool. Alright. 2-0. Flyers. Flyers do work. Flyers and equipment. I'm going to get a quest soon. Alright, that worked. Let's run it back. My average draft tends to be win 2 or 3 games and then just get crapped on and go out 0-3. So, let's see what happens. I'm having fun. That's the important thing. That's the wrong button. We've got 2 cards we can play with our 1 sigil, but we're not going to keep this hand. That's not terrible. Definitely had worse cards in my day. Here's the path book. We can try the path book out, see how it goes. I think I'm best to just play the creature for now. What's that going to do? Exactly 1. Makes him a 2-2. Nah, I'll play creatures for now. Build the board up a little bit at least. Flyers always win. Yeah, that's how I won on Saturday. I built Elysian, whatever it is, white, blue, flyers, and just managed to pull them out at the right time. Yeah, I can take 2 from that. I can silence that if I really want to. I'd like to draw some sigils, please. I think at the moment I'm going to silence that. Yeah. Seems so bad. Yeah, we'll play the Oathbook. Let's try the Oathbook out. I'm not going to try it unless we play it. I'm not going to see what happens unless we play it. Get +1. Oh no, my opponent has a thing. Maybe. Got something they can cast, they're just deciding whether they want to or not. Hello. Cool. Put in some damages. Opponent is on a clock, no, cool. They're gonna sacrifice that, they're gonna put that on that. That's fine. Place some kind of creature, I'm guessing, to try and hold up my board. I could silence that. Kind of glad I saved my rebuke. Now I can just keep attacking in the air. Ooh, getting aggressive. Actually, I don't need to silence it because it'll get to 3, won't it? Yeah, but I can't do anything else, so. Yeah. Yeah, I was like, oh, if I get my sigil, I can start getting that on, and then there's this. If I was drawing sigils, this game would be a lot, pretty much over already. I might silence this, just to try and get this damage in. Hit for 5. Don't get the Oathbook trigger, but I still get 5 damage in, so not too upset. If he doesn't attack with the spider, then I'll just keep hitting with the aspirant and slowly doing more damage. Opponent's very much on Stone Scar Sacrifice. Graveyard shenanigans. That's fine. My creatures ain't dying anytime soon. There's my sigil, so we'll attack for 3 in the air. Play the sigil, and then I think we'll play the flyer. Do we want Warcry or Lifesteal? That's the question. Maybe Warcry. Decisions. Go Warcry. Try and get some bigger guys out. Well, there goes that. Oh no, now I can only attack with one creature. Whatever will I do? You got a 5/5. Alright, you're gonna get to draw a card. I need to draw a white source to get my Carbon Guardian online. I'm thinking no attacks. I'm at 5/11, so I've got 2 turns, so I'll attack. I'll play this guy, then next turn I'll just weapon it up and start gain full life from the attack. Oh, I should get this one again. Block. I don't know, I'm attacking anyway, so let's do that. The question is, do I play the Paladin or the Bird? Paladin's more life, but it could get blocked either. I suppose it'd go to 6, won't it? Have to throw. Oh, it can be blocked by the spider. I'll play the Bird. I don't know, this could be wrong. I'm not afraid to admit that I'm not the best. 7/4 damage could be done by multiple things. If I block there, I take 6, gain 1, lose 1. I'm gonna risk it. It's probably not a great idea, but let's see what my opponent has. Yeah. 9, 10, 11. Damn it. Oh well. Should've blocked, should've played the... Should've done a few things differently there. But that's fine. quests. Getting stuck on two land really hurt there too. Two sigils, two power, whatever they want to call it. Alright, let's try that one again. This is an iffy one. I've got two cards I can play, one's a creature and one's a spell. Average hand's probably worse than this, but I'm going second. I think we're redrawing. Yeah, let's redraw. That's better. I can play every card in my library. Yep. Every card in my hand, I should say. That was worth it. Oh yeah. 100%. Now, there could be arguments for keeping it, you know, but it's very risky and there's really no point to. With the guarantee, with the way obviously the game's mulligans work, there's really no reason not to. If it was a Magic game, I'd probably be less likely. So that's getting silenced. Oh yeah, it's really good. Like, I mean, you get some that are just crap, but like generally it's still so much better than Magic in that aspect. Okay, let's just silence that one as well. Won't block, no reason to. Do I want to just dispel that straight away? Or do I want to play this guy? Oh yeah, that's the worst thing in Magic is where you have the hand that the 7 that's okay but not great, and then you have to mulligan down to like 4 because that's the next time you see a land. I'm just going to dispel this straight away. I'm not saying Eternal Magic or Eternal is better, I'm saying in this aspect, Magic is... Eternal wins. The question is, if I don't play my sigil, that means this becomes bigger, but it's two. I can play this and then put that on it, and it's probably just better to develop the mana. Yeah, let's develop the mana. Might block this time. Yeah, and yeah, 100%. Like, that's the thing that most people, and I mean, I love about Magic is that it has the paper version, the aspect of it, and the online game has to match that, otherwise it's just not the same game. So there's never going to be a way to fix it, and you know, some of the best parts of Eternal are things that just cannot happen on Magic. Like, I love Warcry. Warcry is like my favourite thing in this whole game because it's just awesome. And that just cannot happen in Magic because you can't. Exactly, yeah. Like, Magic could make it happen on the online version, but yeah, and the fact that they use. Oh yeah, so good. The fact that they use Magic Online things, like they have the Pro Tour qualifiers, they have the mocks, which all relate back to the Paper Magic qualifiers. It could just never happen and still be considered part of the same game. Like, they might be able to do it on Duels, but who plays Duels? It's just not it's not as good. cards that mimic Warcry effects, like what? The opponent knows that it doesn't get its abilities back. I'll put this on here, and I'm going to play my sigil. Get an 8-8. 12-12. Oh yeah, because it... yeah. Yeah. It's tricky because, obviously there's no way to manipulate the deck without knowing what's going to happen in the deck. There are some, like, in Conspiracy, there's cards that you name a card and when you play it, they do whatever. Kind of wish I'd put the thing on him, but oh well. Ready? Oh yeah, 24-24. Just silence that. Maybe just silence the fly. What am I at? 10, 4, 6, 8, 10. Oh shit, okay. Silence the biggest one maybe, just to stop it from being an attacker. Yeah, right. One creature short of being safe to win. Problem is if I attack, if he has a removal, I just die. 2, 4, 6, 7. So I need to silence that to... suppose I attack. He's got to block with the 1-3. Oh, it's a 4-4. Yeah, that's right. And then I'll stun this. Just to make sure I don't die. Would hate to die to... yeah, like the last game. When I play my Lexland, he's going to become a... what, 44? Oathbook is... okay, yeah. I apologise for accusing you of trolling me. It's solid. That's not going to do it. That's not going to do it. I don't want to block this one, obviously. I'll block that. If he has that same card that killed me last time, I'm going to be very upset. So if I don't, it'll kill me. So 2. Yeah, see what I get. Opponent's got some fast spell. Ooh, hello. Ooh, let's do this. Ah, conceded. 28, so it would have been... what's double 28? I should know that. 28, so it'd be 56? 56 damage in his face? Alright, 3 wins. This is my usual point, so let's see if we can push to a fourth. I do have some good rares in this deck, I'll admit. Like, I've got the Silence Flying Guy and the Oath Book, apparently. Both solid cards. Kind of wish I was able to play my Ikaria or whatever her name is, but... Didn't want to get greedy and splash a triple red card. Yeah, Valkyrie and the Oath Book. So nice cards that help win games. Yeah, that's not what I want to do. I think I've got, yeah, Oathbook, Enforcer. Did I get any other rares that I'm playing? He's rare. There you go. He's fine. I don't know. I've played him a couple of times, and he's not always that good, but he's pretty solid. Let's see what else I got. No other rares. I don't know how this system works. It was pretty solid that game. When you put that weapon on it and draw nothing but sigils, it's actually pretty solid. Casual 56-56. If only it had Overwhelm. Surreal. This one is not capable. Can't be worse. Okay, it can be worse. Hello. Yeah, I like the little guys that have the ultimate, so you just chuck 8 mana into them and they get slightly better. They're pretty solid. Alright, we got the green source. So next turn we play this guy, or this guy, I don't know, we'll see what happens. I really like this card, I don't know why, I've always liked this card, like, literally since day one of playing. It's like, oh, it's pretty cool, like, you know, it's nothing over the top exciting, but I don't know, I just like it. When I was just starting out, I was the only deck I would play was the Justice pre-made deck, and I'd just run that through the, not the Forge, but the other one. Oh, you're a killer. That was just fun. Hey, thanks for the follow, buddy. Sorry. Get some flies in the air, then silence his flies and win the game, hey? Sorry, silence my opponent's flies and win the game. Maybe it's silence this next turn. Fun. I usually Eternal's probably the least that I stream because I started off really well drafting and then I got really crappy and then I didn't for whatever reason just couldn't win. So then I stopped playing for about a month and then I got a bit bored playing Magic last night on Saturday night my normal stream and I was like yeah I'll play some Eternal and then I happened to 7-0 and then 3-3 and had some fun. I was like yeah I've got time tonight I'll do it again. I've actually just downloaded Gwent. I got my beta key a while ago, but I was away from home, so I forgot about it. And I'll, this time, tomorrow night, I should be doing Gwent. I've literally never played it. I've got a buddy who has played the paper version, and apparently it's a paper version. So he's going to run me through it. He's going to be on the stream with me, and yeah. I'll hopefully learn how to not suck at it and see how fun it is. Is it, I mean, hella fun? Awesome. I'll admit, I've never ever played Witcher. A lot of people tend to, I don't know, try and crucify me for that, but I'm hoping that doesn't affect my enjoyment of the game. Okay, cool. Yeah, it definitely seems interesting. This is what happened there. All my units get killed. I've literally never seen that card before. Best art of any CCG, best premium cards, completely different system from other games on market. Okay, cool. Yeah, like, I mean, I'm a long-term Magic player, and I love playing Magic. Hearthstone, I've got to admit, I'm not a big fan of, but I do play it, and then I found Eternal, and obviously fell in love with Eternal, so, yeah. Is that one of the new ones, or is it just, I've just never seen it? So he's going to kill this, not that, not. Still pretty close to dead. I like endurance is good. Yeah, I can see why you'd pick one. Pick one. We're just going to keep attacking with everything. We're winning this race by far. Play little guys. He's probably going to kill off this. 2, 5, 6, and he's dead. I suppose he kills this, I think he's not. Yeah. Sweet. That's the one upside of playing in the silver leagues is that you tend to find a couple of people who aren't. Oh shit! What happened there? I should be paying attention to this game for one. Oh shit. Do I kill it or do I just let it hit me? So he goes to 12. It's still got, doesn't have endurance anymore. Goes to 12. He takes 3, 6, 8. Let's just not block it this turn. See what happens. I'm actually kind of not paying attention. I'm having more fun chatting with you guys than I am than actually paying attention to the game. So, does that win? 5, 7, 10. Puts him on 2. Oh, got an echo. Take 10. Oh, jeez. Wish I'd got the sigil there. Is that wrong? 3, 4, yeah, no, it's fine. I need another rebuke. If I draw my rebuke, that's just game. I'll probably chump it this turn. Chump at the. It's not 8, you can go back up to 18. Okay, so I'm gonna kill that. That's fine. Do a chumperoonie there. So he goes to 5-5, so become an 8-8. If I get the sigil, that's pretty much game, right? Gain 5 life. Creatures. Thanks, mate. Thanks for hanging out. So, if you're around tomorrow night, I'll be playing Gwent. So, a little bit of Hearthstone, then Gwent. So, maybe you can tell me what to do. So, we're going to use this ability. Thanks for the follow, Harry. So I can attack and then I can block the 10-7 with my 8-8 and then put myself in a better position. Ah, no, I can't. Fuck me. Guess I'm just going to start jumping. So it's 17. This freaking thing. I'm not even hitting him for more than he's gaining, which is really annoying. I'm staying alive in the game, and I have live draws. I'm sure my opponent does as well. Back up to 18. Yeah, chumperoonies. Maybe I should have chucked a few guys ahead, you know, on that a while back. There it is. That should pretty much be game. My opponent will need to draw, needs to draw something good to keep this game going. I love Rebuke. I love Rebuke. Seriously. Oh yeah. This is luck. Definitely fluked it. It's just the way I play. Come on, nothing. That's lethal if my opponent doesn't have a flyer. All according to plan. Wait, I need to say, I need to say thanks, I'm a dick. Dear opponent, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to be a dick there. Alright, we got the four. Three to go. Let's do this. Currently running above average. Vagrant. Not too bad, thanks. Crack, four wins in, so that's, you know, that's fun. I could keep this, being that it's got the Seek into nothing. No, we're going to redraw. Slightly better. Need to draw more sigils, preferably a time sigil. Thanks for the follow, Crack. Normally I'd block instantly, but I've shot nothing else. Yeah, let's block. I hate Warcry. I hate when my opponent Warcries. I can maybe turn him on. Yeah, damn it. Ah, cool, we got the time sigil. Let's just play. Yeah, we'll play this. Hopefully, we can find a way to give it plus one to start lifelinking and get myself out of range of his aggro stuff. Sweet. So we can either silence that or we can make a 2-2. I think we're fine to make a 2-2 for now. And we're not attacking yet. We're going to try and hold back and build up the board a bit. Got it. Not a sigil, that's fine. Spice straight away. There's the sigil. Get a 4-4. Play this. And turn. Luckily my opponent's not going as aggressively as I expected. Exhaust that, yeah, that makes sense. Oh, we can take a hit for three. Right, now I think we'll drop the fly to start trying to get some damage in. As it has seemed to work every other game. Surely my opponent doesn't have another one of these. Next time I can play the 5-5, get some armor. Do I want to block this? I don't think I do. I'll give another turn or two before I start aggressively blocking. Sweet. Okay, so we'll put that on... I'm going to put it on this to see if we can get higher than we did last time, but let's do the sensible play. Yes, sensible play. I could silence that to get rid of the quick draw, and then just block with it. Or I can I should have put that lifelink. Yeah, I should put the lifelink over here as well. Yeah, a few mistakes there. How worried am I about a torch? Not really. Not blocking it or else am I? Yeah. Take 8. Oh wait, that was stupid. Yep, okay. I've probably lost this game for myself. Let's see what happens. I get 4 armor. Get an 8-8. And yeah, if I put this on him, yep, got distracted. That was silly. Alright, no attacks. That's a nice card. Okay, that'll come in handy. Pass. Chuck this in to turn this off. Hurry up, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 creatures. If I have 5 blockers, that means 3 creatures are getting through and I'm taking 1, 2, 5. Yeah, I need to start attacking. It's a 3 turn clock, so... yes, I have some nice big friends on the board. If I draw another sigil, I can turn this into an 8-8. He attacks with everything. Okay, that's cool too. Is there anything worth stunning at the moment? I can silence this, because torch... I mean, torch could be the difference between winning and losing the game, couldn't it? This is the only other thing that has an ability that matters. Drawing Justice Sigils helps him thin his deck... helps my opponent thin their deck a bit. I'm going to stun this one. I just don't want him to, don't want my opponent to draw a torch, which kills me. Could be wrong. Happy to admit that could be a mistake, but... oh, yep. So that was a mistake. Shit. I suppose I can still attack, because I have to trade. Well, I can attack with this, so if you have to give me 2 creatures for this one. Not doing anything else, so I'm definitely using the ability. Four blocks, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. No, I can't attack that. No, I have to attack with that. If there's a way to give it too tough, which I don't think there really is. Let's see what happens. This could be wrong. Block, block. Don't, damn it. Don't tell me don't. Ah, I just killed myself, didn't I? Like, if he just attacks with everything, am I just dead? 8. 9, 10. That had overwhelm. 7, 14, dead. Ah, well. Don't be afraid of torches. Save your stuns. Lesson for the day. Alright, we've got one more loss. Or 3 more wins. Whatever comes first. So my two game losses were from stupid mistakes, and my 4 game wins were mostly just from fluking the crap out of it. So, you know, par for the course. This I can keep. 2 drop into this thing, into this thing. Do the play that I should have done last game and gain a whole ton of life. Ah, for sure. I'm not gonna lose sleep over it. It's just, it's annoying when it's there and you should have seen it and you didn't. Thing. So opponent's going to gain some life, and I'm going to start beating his face for 7. No box. Don't like my opponent getting cards, but you know. Annoying, but fine. If he blocks, that means my guy goes back down to being a 3-3. I only get, yeah, it's fine. If I get my life out of range of being in trouble, that works too. Never been able to make Haunting Scream work. I tried to draft this deck a few times, and it just never comes together for me. Save some armor. Probably won't block this thing. Attack for 4. question is, do I want to... I'll end turn. I can always ambush and block this. Yep, you got a 2-2. Definitely don't let that thing get out of hand. It tends to get pretty big if you let it. We'll block. He's done his work. He can die. Alright, let's see if we can get some super big shenanigans again. Oh, no, he's going to kill it. No, don't do that. No. Bastard. Ah, well. I've got a 4-4 with Aegis. Let's just make it bigger. And 6. That's not worth stunning, so let's make sure we don't stun the wrong thing again. Bubble. That's better than nothing, right? Put his flyer on the ground. All the answers over here. Seriously? Alright, well that can get stunned too. Don't want another one of those guys. Might as well hold the land. This is not looking good. Another Haunting Dreams. Oh well. We got to 4 wins. 4 wins is, I said, above average for me, so... yeah. Look at all this stuff I had. Oh, worst things have happened. I had fun. 3 gold chests. Come on, upgrade. Oh, 1500 gold back. Couple of packs. Some shards. I'll open the pack. Let's open the packs and then I'll probably just call it a night. Alright, legendaries. Boom. Hey, Paladin Oathbook. I heard that card is really good if you can cast it in draft. Just what I heard. Can't believe how good that actually was when it got played. Hey, look, there's that card that the other guy played and then I beat him with because he played pretty badly. It's like a walk down memory lane tonight. Hey, I opened a Clockroach in the draft. I didn't take it, because... I don't know. Because it's not very good by itself. Legendary. There we go. Plora the First Dragon. Play 4 random 1-cost units on a tomb. That seems pretty cool. I've never seen... As with most legendaries, I've never seen it before. It seems like it'd go fine in a... armory kind of deck. It costs 7, though. Could do work. Coincidences. And we got a Valkyrie Enforcer. Literally 4 of our 5 packs were cards that we saw or used in the draft tonight. So that's interesting. I do already have. Hey, Beast. I just 4-3 to draft with an interesting deck. It wasn't quite as exciting as Saturday night. I'm not tired. Let's just do some ranked. I've just got a random armory deck that I pulled from RNG site, and it's been going well, so play a couple of games while we go. Lever Beaver. Yeah, I'll keep this hand. It's fine. I'm still not 100% with this deck, but it seems pretty straightforward. Play weapons, smash face, win game. We'll play that first. Because you need to try and get the double green up. We'll turn 2 this, turn 3 this, turn 4 this, turn 5 this, win the game. Oh, and have that just in case. Just about to take the weapon, but... Oh, did I? When did I play? What? Which deck were you on? That was wrong. Ooh, that's gonna die. Was it you that I played with the 56-56 Order of the Spire? That was fun. Nah, man, I'm not going to draft again. So, it's getting too late. That's from that, okay. Get this, which weapon do I want? That's the question. I have 5 mana. This is where I always get a bit stuck. Yeah, this isn't draft, this is constructed. We'll take the rune hammer. Could be wrong. Sorry, I should update the Twitch name. Casual scrub ranked. Either that or I watched a stream and you faced him. Okay, yeah, I was just drafting. Were you just in the draft beast, or were you just drafting beast? Alright, let's just harsh rule these guys out. Then I can play my 5 drop and kill that. I'm trying to think who I played against. I didn't really get the times. Pop my bubble, that's not nice. Let's do this. Play that. I may as well. Attack first. Let's see if he blocks. Come on, take the block. Do it. I may as well turn this on. This is why you don't overcommit to the board, kids. Oh, you got a thing. Damn it. That's nice. I hate this card. If you play that card, you're probably a D-bag. Wait, if I play this first, then I don't lose my weapon. I get how things work. I can double block. Yeah. Stupid 1-1 guy again. Hey, people who just keep recurring that card. Really annoys me. I get that's what the deck does, but. I'm not sure how this actually... Does this let me attack again if I've already attacked once when I play it? Yep. Alright, so I'm pretty dead. Let's see what happens, hey? As all the pro players do, my deck list is still all the original starter decks that you get, plus two imported decks. I have fun with it. I don't care too much about ranked. It's more of just a time killer. See if we can do the same thing, but just a little bit better. Yeah. This hand is not terrible, but not great. You're alright, Beast, so I'll just play another game or two and then. I'll be heading to bed anyway. Thanks for dropping in. Okay, so we're gonna turn one, turn two, and a quarry again. Woo, Justice Sigils. That's exciting. Play a creature so I can silence it, please. I hate when they don't play creatures for you to silence. It's on four color something. Question is, do I want to play the Throne Warden or do I just want to inspire? I think we'll inspire. See what we get. Yeah, that wasn't worth it. That's fine, that's fine. We've got the mana to play Ikaria if we draw her, so that's fun. That's not Ikaria. Play that. Drop this guy. Have torches available if he plays anything. Expecting some four colour shenanigans to happen very shortly. Well, that's useful right now, isn't it? Attack. This is a very fun and interactive game. Respond to that? Yeah, I can. What is it whenever you play a unit with 5 or more, it comes back? I need a way to silence it. Oh wait, I have a way to silence it. Maybe I should. Oh, next door. A carrier? Not a carrier. A carrier? Still not a carrier. I'm probably saying that wrong as well. Forgive me if I am. Because it's just going to get lightning struck again. Actually, maybe I should let it. See if he tries to give it a killer. Yeah, cool. Yeah, it's going to get killed. Bye bye. Cool. Alright, we got there. And on that note, while I'm ahead, I might call that a night and go to bed. Ooh, 50 gold. And a shard. Alrighty, well, thanks for dropping in. Thanks for watching. Hope you had fun. Feel free to follow and hang out. I do this a couple of times a week and play various card games. I have Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, Discord, all the normal stuff. Say hi, otherwise have a great night, or great day, or whatever it may be where you are.
Yeah, and thanks for coming.